Whenever I think of home, I always have a picture in my mind. But it's a place that doesn't quite exist anymore. Somewhere in the hallowed halls of my childhood memories. It's a place I went to where my grandparents lived. And in the summer, we'd go out with my extended family, cousins, aunts, siblings, and parents, of course, just to hang. You know, the sun would be blazing, so we'd go by the nearest spring and jump right in. And at night, the stars would fill the sky because there was little to no light in the countryside back then. And of course, the 5 to 10 year old me did not give a crap how amazing the world was. There's a reason why I led with a nostalgic story about what it was like back then for me, because the game we're gonna be talking about today is just the right sauce of nostalgia and sentimental, but mixed with the absurdity of being a kid, and the absurdity of being Shin Chan. So for context, this game is based off a show called Shin Chan, and it's not a kid show by any means. The main character is a kid, but he's sort of an idiot, but he gets himself in trouble all of the time. And the charm of the show is all the misadventures he gets from trying to outsmart his parents from chores, or tries to go full absurd by, I don't know, fighting Godzilla or something. It's been running since 1992, and they have not run out of ideas that... Oh, wait, hold up. The game is as old as me. I feel like I need to step back a little bit, because wow, this game feels just like an extension of the world of Shin Chan, the show. It takes Shin Chan on an adventure across the countryside into the town of Aso, because Misai wanted to hang out with a childhood friend. Misai is the mom, by the way. So she brings her whole family with her. Hilarity ensues. On the way, Shin meets a professor and gets a magic camera, and that's all the setup you need.
So it's official. Every moron in town has an air conditioner but us.
Do you folks need an air conditioner?
Oh, no, we have 1, 2, 3, actually. We're just looking for a spare.
Don't mind her. She's loopy from breaking our fan with her head. Now she's all bald on one side.
Shin, can I see you on this?
Little family conference. Excuse us.
After some dialogue, the game just lets you go. It doesn't tell you what to do or where to go. You literally are free to explore wherever you want in the town. It's after running around town and talking to people that you get what it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be an adventure game. You run around, look for scenes and story elements to trigger, and Shin writes them down in his picture book. The town is very small, but there's a whole bunch of story to just stumble yourself into. Some are really bizarre, and some are atypical for being kids. You know, you got a storyline where you get a secret hideout and you play a bunch of Pokemon cards in it. Some storylines involve setting people's love lives up. Some involve running a newspaper company. And, you know, basic kid stuff. There's a whole bunch of story to uncover in this game. And due to the cast of characters not being too big, the plot threads aren't that hard to follow. The highest praise I can give this game, like the best feature about this game, is its very atmosphere, man. The director of this game knew what moment in time they wanted to capture, and captured it perfectly. There's just a warmth to it that just reminds me of some long gone days, like I said in the beginning of the video. There's just a feeling of nostalgia of being small and running around with grown-ups paying you no mind. It's just like that. Looking over where your dad has some drinking buddies over, and then catching your aunt or mom with your baby sister sitting down watching TV. Outside, the neighbors with their kids telling stories and how you could walk right by and join in. I mean, this director, I don't know him personally, but I feel like we had the same childhood, man. This guy knew how to capture that image of childhood in very vivid detail. There's some added things in the game where it's just, you know, very, very little minute details like that that adds to the nostalgia and immersion. Like mom nagging you to brush your teeth at night. Who doesn't remember that? Or when you go out and have an adventure, and then they'd send someone over to call you back because it's getting quite late. They didn't have to add that in the game. They didn't have to do it that way. They could have just had, like, you know, a time limit and then transition you over to your bedtime. No. They put it in the game because they knew exactly what they wanted to present. They knew exactly the type of feeling they wanted to present. There's also things like sleeping together in a very small cramped space because the host's house wasn't built for that many visitors, and to add, the table being bunched together unevenly because of course the host doesn't normally have that many people over, so they just bunched together like different tables just to have everybody in the same position. Jeez, the detailing, the direction of the game is immaculate, man. I really feel like these moments were lived through by the developers, which is why it feels so vivid. This isn't the only game they made about childhood moments, though. Attack of the Friday Night Monsters was also by the same team, and that had the same feel to it, man. And I'd want to talk about that game one of these days, but I digress. The atmosphere is indeed excellent, and it captures rural Japan quite well. But how about the game? How does it play? Well, okay, to set expectations, of course, even without knowledge of Shin Chan, you need to know that this game is a story-driven adventure game. There's no combat, and you're really just there to take in the atmosphere and the story. The game can be bogged down to the activities you do around the story, but there's quite a lot to do in this mountain retreat. Shin goes through a lot and makes a lot of friends, and causes a lot of trouble for some. You get to do a bunch of errands that include farming, catching, and classifying bugs and fish, playing some weird dinosaur trading card game, riding cable cars, doing embarrassing dances, going on dates, learning about fossils, learning about ancient dinosaur tamers, making newspaper articles, becoming a DJ, eating chocobees, most of all making a ton of memories. There's a lot of variety in the daily activities, but there is a catch though. You have to make the most of it in a week. The full title of the game is called Me and the Professor on Summer Vacation, The Endless 7-Day Journey. And you can extrapolate what you want from the title, but the clue is there. But I won't tell you. It's up to you. But yeah, there's a certain time-based element to it that extends to the story. It's weird. It's charming at the same time. So as far as gameplay goes, all the little activities, yeah, it's fun. The game is stacked with stuff to do, so you're never really bored in that sense. But for a story-driven game, though, how's the story? How's the dialogue writing? How is it? Well, let me be honest with you. It's gonna be a mixed bag for some. The plot is absurd. Absurd in a funny way. I don't really want to spoil anything, but let's just say the motivation for the whole plot is so stupid that it's endearing. A lot of it doesn't make sense, but honestly, it's a very typical Shin Chan adventure to be goofy and wacky and absurd. And if you're coming into that with no knowledge of what that is, you're gonna be put off. And where it gets very iffy for me is the execution. Because in the show, the delivery of the jokes with the voice acting and the animation makes the jokes land stronger. But in the game, they're really tied to text bubbles and voice acting and character animation, and the character animation aren't stiff, but since it's a 3D model, there's only so much expression that you can make out of it. Not everything is voiced too, so if you're reading Shin's bad puns, it's not quite as funny. Yeah, speaking of 3D models though, I really like how well they made the 3D models. Shin Chan, let's face it, you look at it, it's got a lot of squiggly lines, especially Misaya and Hiroshi, but you're thinking, how the heck would they implement that in 3D? And they really did it well. Pretty sure the other characters are sort of the same models, but tweaked though. The brothers Giro, I don't know, are just recolors of each other. It's so weird. But for the most part, the models are very impressive in its own way. The backgrounds and the backdrop are very breathtaking, honestly. That's what sold me on this game. I mean, look at it. It's gorgeous. It looks and smells like the countryside. People might not like the single point camera though. Modern games have gotten so used to first person or third person, the rotating camera, that a single point camera might be jarring, but because the camera stays at one point, the director can frame the scene however he wants, and it really builds on the atmosphere and immersion. Some shots are really far, and some shots are from lower to the ground, which emphasizes how small Shin is relative to the world, and I really like that. And the differing angles will feel jarring to the controller, but as somebody who's played through classic Resident Evil, this didn't bother me at all, but I can understand if somebody, like, feels weird about it. My last bit of criticism is more of a nitpick coming from a fan of the show, and even if I nitpick it, I know exactly why they did it that way. I want to say, for the first open adventure Shin Chan game, why isn't it set in Kaskabe? Yes, it's a real place, and maybe that's going to be some legal issue with that, and yes, the game probably wasn't built with too much of a budget. Even if a new setting lets you focus on Shin's family more and less of the side characters, I'm still going to ask why. Why? Why isn't it in Kaskabe, man? I mean, it's okay. I really can't do anything about it now. Like, but imagine if you had a Simpsons game, and it's in Canada instead of Springfield. Like, why? Overall, it was really a decent experience. It's honestly carried by its atmosphere, maybe dragged down by the story execution a little bit, but I didn't really hate it. It didn't overstay its welcome, and it told a light, funny Shin Chan story. I didn't come out of it regretting the experience, but of course, something in me wished there was a bit more to it. Honestly, after the story was over, I was left with the feeling of, that was nice, but that's it? It really felt like we just coasted through a few days, you know? I felt the same way with Attack on the Friday Monsters too. Attack of the Friday Night Monsters? It just felt, I don't know, anticlimactic, less grand. Feels kind of lame, but it is what it is. Kind of like when you're a kid. It's how life usually is when you're a kid. You're rarely in control, and a summer vacation is over whether you want it to go longer or not. By the end of the trip, I clocked in at 10 hours, which really is an important indicator for me whether or not I'll engage with the game. The time it takes to finish it, honestly, it's not too bad. Despite it needing a little bit more, I'm glad it didn't overstay because, you know, going past, like, I was getting a little bit frustrated with it. But overall, this was a nice atmospheric game, a nice callback and view as to how it was, really. And it resonates with me as a person. Did it resonate with me as a Shin Chan fan? I'll have to think of that more. But I think it was a fun little Shin Chan adventure. Like, the game knows how to set a scene and make an atmosphere, but I don't know if
the game being Shin Chan even mattered, though. Like, the game has a lot of heart. Did it actually need to be Shin Chan, is the question. As a representation of the franchise, though, it lacks impact, is what I'm trying to say. But I appreciate it for what it is. I appreciate it. I like it.
Honestly, the game is fine. It won't change your life or anything. You'll just have a nice time with Shin. And if you're invested in Shin Chan, I'll probably give you like a 70% of a recommendation. But if you're curious about Shin Chan, I'll probably give you a 20% recommendation to try it. If you look at the game and think that it's a nice atmosphere and it might give you a nice time, I'll give you like 50% of a recommendation, I guess. For an optimal Shin Chan experience, watch a few episodes of the show to see Shin at his best.
But as for this game, I leave it in my memories. And maybe one of these days I can come back to it, because it just has this nice atmosphere, and it is a game with a lot of heart. So I can see myself playing this game one of these days when I'm stressed and I want to go back to the countryside, but I physically can't. So maybe I can put this game out and have a nice time and spend the summer with Shin Chan again. Thanks for watching, everybody. Good night.
Kara